Did you take a shower or no? Are you gonna go downstairs now?
The school district superintendent, Hal Harrell, has announced plans to begin the process of retiring. That comes on the same day the district suspended its entire police force until further notice. CNN Crime and Justice correspondent Shimon Procupes has more on that and the ongoing investigation.
The Uvalde School District suspending all of its officers, pulling them out of the schools in Uvalde and putting them into administrative roles. All of this, of course, happening after our reporting that a newly hired officer who came from the DPS, she resigned from the Department of Public Safety and was hired by the school district, despite the fact that she was under investigation for her response while at the DPS to the Robb Elementary School. The school somehow, some way hired her, even though they knew, they were told by the DPS that she was under investigation. Also, a school administrator by the name of Ken Miller was also suspended. He retired. Because of that suspension, he decided he's just going to retire. And then also, Lieutenant Miguel Hernandez. He's the lieutenant, he's the commanding officer of the school police force. He also was placed on administrative leave. And what our understanding is, this lieutenant was the one who was behind vetting that officer, Officer Elizondo, newly hired officer by the school district. And so really the school district here responded in decisive form, taking all of their officers out, removing this administrator, and then also suspending this lieutenant. Of course, this is all welcome news for the families who've been fighting for justice, who've been fighting for accountability, wanting the school to take this kind of action, certainly after our report, but also since the shooting, wanting accountability for the failures, but also the failures that they believe occurred by the school district. We're also told, on one final note, is that the superintendent, how he plans to retire, that announcement is expected sometime, possibly on Monday. So certainly a big shakeup there in Uvalde, something that the families didn't think they would get, but finally some accountability for them, offering them some relief.
Our thanks to Shimon Procupes for his excellent reporting on that story. So, more than a week has passed since Hurricane Ian made its deadly landfall, but for some folks in Florida, restoration and recovery efforts are still strained and slow going.
You gonna be here, bro?
No, I'm going with you.
Can I make the coffee?
Yeah. Yeah.
You want to go down with me when I make the coffee?
Yeah. I don't want to hear no news about this. Sad news over again, you know?
Yeah, I know.
It's hard to face what bad, evil person that was.